In today's video, Retro Biosciences' $180 million man, AI-focused biotech startups rake in the cash, and stem cell research goes off-planet. Welcome to Longevity Roundup, three stories in 3 minutes. Let's get started. ChatGPT founder and OpenAI CEO Sam Altman has recently come out as the mystery investor who plunked down $180 million into Retro Biosciences, a biotech company on a mission to add 10 years to human life. Silicon Valley has become the hub for companies and investors interested in life extension, with Altos Labs funded partly by Jeff Bezos, Google spinning off Calico Labs, and New Limit co-founded by Coinbase CEO Brian Armstrong, to name just a few. Retro Biosciences plan to use their collective knowledge of cellular reprogramming, autophagy, and plasma-inspired therapeutics to extend human life, and they'll use machine learning technology to help get them there. A quick thanks to channel partner DoNotAge.org, a health and longevity research company that sells the highest quality supplements. Click my link in the description or use discount code STARK for 10% off every purchase. In other funding news, generative AI has attracted attention from biotech startups looking to speed up processes like drug discovery and DNA sequencing. Startups like Themia, Cradle, and Evazine are utilizing machine learning models to diagnose mental illnesses, design and alter proteins more efficiently, and create novel proteins, respectively. Generative AI can take large-scale datasets to better predict trial outcomes and turn data into insights that can speed up the development of drugs. However, the sector is still in its early stages, and training AI datasets can be expensive and time-consuming. Despite its limitations, generative AI has attracted significant investment. Biotech startups raised $29.5 billion in 2022. And finally, stem cells may be easier to grow in microgravity conditions, prompting scientists from Cedars Sinai and Axiom Space to explore the possibility of manufacturing them in space laboratories. Stem cells are used for different medical applications, including cell-based therapies and research. However, large-scale manufacturing on Earth is challenging due to the pull of gravity. The researchers believe that microgravity conditions on the International Space Station will make stem cells easier to grow. Astronauts will conduct experiments to test this idea during the AX-2 flight, scheduled for May 9th. The goal is to confirm earlier studies that have shown that more of these cells can be grown faster in orbit. If successful, this could pave the way for launching biomedical labs in space. Thanks for watching. Links to articles related to today's topics are in the description below. Please subscribe to House of Longevity if you haven't yet, and give this video a thumbs up.